like too much because of the time difference. You know, you guys would play like games at 2 a.m. in Serbian time, so I couldn't watch. But, like, I know the team, I know the players, most of them. I know like Trae Young, obviously. You know, I watched Bogey, Clint Capella, you know, all of those guys. So haven't heard from them. I hope I will soon. I just heard from Bogey. He posted on his story, "Welcome to Atlanta." So that's nice.
And for me, like, kind of the same. We're from the same continent, so it's kind of hard to follow games because it's at night for us. But yeah, just, you know, really exciting to join the team, and I think I can be good with all of these guys, and I can't wait to meet them, you know.
Zach, my name is Ken Segura. I'm a writer with the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. I apologize in advance. I think some of the questions I want to ask you may have been asked by our French colleagues. Nous ne parlons bien le français, so je m'excuse. But can you tell us about maybe your first dreams of playing in the NBA, and then also now that you are almost here, kind of your thoughts about what you think it might be like?
This is crazy how I feel since today, like since the draft. But yeah, like you said, that's basically a dream come true, and all the work that I put in my entire life finally pays off, you know, and that just motivate me and to do more, you know. And I think this is great how things work, because I realized my dream 2 days ago, and now I have other dreams, and I want to obviously do more, and yeah, all the goals, and I can't wait to get into work so I can realize another dream, and that's, I think, the most important.
Kevin Chenard, Hawks.com. This is a question for both Zachary and Nikola. Growing up as a kid, did you have a favorite NBA player that you'd like to watch?
So, I love a lot of players growing up, but if I had to choose someone, it would be Kevin Durant.
I mean, I would say one player, but I wasn't born yet, so I watched his highlights. Michael Jordan, so yeah.
Terrell Thomas, these Urban Times. Nicole, I wanted to follow up on the question and see how do you feel like your game in Serbia has prepared you for the NBA game?
I mean, definitely the experience, you know, play against grown men. You learn a lot of stuff from those guys, you know, especially in my in Mega this year. I had like a coach. He was a super coach. I had like an ex-player, Novica Veličković, you know, he was like a legend back in Serbia. So I learned a lot from him. So yeah, like overall the experience, you know, playing against like the grown men for multiple years. So your body adapts better, I think. So that's like the main thing.
This is for Landry Charles Odom with the Associated Press. Can I ask you to look ahead now, now that you're post-draft? Does yesterday's trade, can that in any way be seen as an indicator of your possible willingness to move other veteran players? As you know, there may be some rumors out there.
Yeah, well, being consistent in saying we're always going to look for ways to improve the team. I think for today, though, like the real focus is on these guys and what we did at the draft.
This is for Landry back here from Brad Rowland from Dime. Obviously, you drafted a couple of wings, perimeter guys. There's lots of talk around the league about the premium placed on wing players and versatility. How do you sort of view your mindset and, you know, targeting these two players and how that fits into the overall emphasis on those wing players?
Yeah, I mean, regardless of position, I mean, these guys compete. And you know, what we, amongst many things, like their IQ for the game, I think playing with this team and playing under head coach Quinn Snyder, it's going to take a level of IQ to pick up things that we want to do. The creativity that he has, he and the coaching staff, they do a tremendous job with our guys. So in order to best serve them and set us up for success, you know, we have to have players that are going to be able to kind of follow along and be able to see, read, respond. And whether that comes from point guards or wings or bigs, like, it's always going to be the case. And for these guys, just playing at that wing position with the athleticism scores that they have and the size that they have and just different components about their games, the versatility, you know, that gives us a really nice canvas for our group and allows our coaches something really fun to work with.
Landry, you touched on a little bit before, but can you go back to just maybe whatever it was in a conversation with the staff that, that finally put Zach over the top that made him your clear number one?
Yeah, I mean, I've touched on a lot of things before. Things to add to that, right? Or like, he's got great size. Shooting is at a premium in the NBA, and a guy of his size and at that caliber of player to have that as well is tremendous. And I think for him and for both these guys, their commitment on both sides of the ball as well, and how we see their upside defensively is another component to this too, that for us, you know, like, again, amongst who they are as human beings, is what set it over the edge for us. Yes. Me and who? Oh, yeah, yeah. Came down to two. Narrowed it down to two that last day.
Zach, juste devant encore, est-ce que tu peux nous raconter en quoi ta saison à la Gielbourg a été un tournant, au final un bon choix et un petit peu fondateur dans ton début de carrière NBA et surtout la venue avec toi d'Anthony à Bourg?
Ça a été une saison décisive pour moi. J'ai appris énormément en peu de temps. C'était ce que je recherchais. Voilà, pouvoir me développer avec des joueurs d'expérience et pouvoir avoir un rôle et des responsabilités dans un groupe d'expérience et un groupe compétiteur. Et voilà, donc j'ai mis le travail pour répondre aux exigences avec, comme t'as dit, Anthony, où on a pu travailler pendant 10 mois en parallèle des entraînements et des attentes collectives qui étaient forcément les matchs, les déplacements et tout. On a réussi à caler et à organiser des temps importants d'entraînement pour pouvoir me développer et devenir meilleur. Et je pense que là, ça a été super bien managé et que voilà, ça a donné quelque chose de super positif.
One last question.
Landry, if I could ask, how do you believe that both Zachary and Nikola represent the culture of this team and what you guys are hoping to build of the culture moving forward?
Well, when we started off, even before this draft, we identify key elements and we have our assessments and we have a number of different criteria that we look into for each player that we bring into Atlanta. So, as I said before, I think our group did a tremendous job and we take all of those assessments and we come to the table and we have our discussions and debates and ideas. And, that's how we do things. So, leaning more into that and watching that evolve over time, the more we learn about this game, the more we learn as a staff, you know, that process will get more and more and more refined, going into next draft period. So I would hope that even as we get closer, just the character of our group, like, our process will continuously get better.
Awesome. Gentlemen, thank you. And to Nico and to Zach, welcome to Atlanta. We're thrilled to have you as a Hawk. This is awesome. We want to make it official. We're going to break into one-on-ones in a moment. But as always, we want to present